pervasive technology to propel objects to space. It's a kind of thruster that uses the properties of, that are very well known, properties of water, which can be used to propel objects using very small thrusters. And now we're making experiments how to make these thrusters as reliable and as small as possible. Currently, we're able to make thrusters that weigh like between 2 to 5 grams per thrusters, per one thruster, but we believe that we can achieve sizes well below 1 gram in near future, which would allow us to make extremely small spacecraft in the range of, let's say, well, my ultimate goal here is to be able to make a spacecraft in the size of a bit larger coin. That would allow humanity to make a lot of interesting missions to space with covering large expanses of the universe, like thousands of swarms of thousands of spacecraft that research asteroids or near Earth objects or so on. And since these are so small, they can do many missions that are impossible with current technology because they cost too much. But here, the cost of one such device and the cost of its launch is very small, so we can afford to research objects that would wait a long, long time before. Device, a rig that's set up to measure the movement of the engine that is placed here. At the moment, it is locked to the magnetic piece here down there, so I have to lift it up to be able to move, which it will not here because it's not a welcome environment here, it's too much pressure, but it will be lifted because it will have to be in the air later. So. It's coming up, so now it's moving. Okay. First, let's see if the power is on. There it is. Okay, that's right. Now, we have to connect this pole to the computer so we can send some commands to it. That's right. This is the control panel now. It's connected now. So to do this, one has to set the amount of water that's let through the valve. That means how much time the valve is open, and the time for which the valve is open. There is a security lock on it, which has to be removed before this can work. So first, let's set level to, let's say, 20. Time to, let's say, 2 seconds, arm the device and start. One cannot hear anything because I haven't plugged everything in yet, and I will turn the power off before I do this, good that something doesn't short out or something like that. Now let's try this next connect again. Yes, it did. Again. Level to 20, time to 2 seconds, arm device and now start. One should hear a clicking sound here when the valve opens and closes. That's it. So it seems that the device works now, so we could put it in the vacuum container, which is on the other side of the room, but it should work. We just have to connect it there. Thank you. Čisto izgubaj, ne?